to talk with.
Don't worry.
But I mean...
Don't worry. I'm used to it. Don't worry. Holy shit. That looks like Suzanne.
She is in the social register.
Jesus Christ. Is that a Picasso?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Edith!
Eddie, how are you?
Swimmingly. May I present Mr.
Scott. Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Fitzgerald. This is Mrs. Warden.
Thank you so much for liking the Great Gatsby.
Well, thank you for coming.
You do like it.
Oh, well, I admire it very much.
You and not a lot of other people.
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Fitzgerald.
Scott.
There'll always be another one. Shall we sit?
I'm sorry. Another?
Well, another novel. Novelists produce novels. Plural.
But I just published this novel. That novel. The Great Gatsby.
Yes. And I wish it a very long life. Shall we sit?
I don't think it will have a long life. I mean, it hasn't gotten the attention I'd hoped, and...
Well, that's the novelist's burden, Mr...
Scott.
Not every novel can become a bestseller.
But I was really hoping to earn an income from this book, and...
None of us are in it to make money. Shall we sit?
Yes, let's all sit.
I will ring for tea. So, Mr. Fitz...
Scott.
Yes, what are you working on?
I just published The Great Gatsby.
Yes, I know. I meant, what is your new book?
That is my new book.
I meant, what new project are you working on?
Well, it's been pretty hard to focus.
Why is that?
Because my book isn't doing well.
Dear, dear.
And I was thinking it would do a lot better with more advertising.
Oh?
I was thinking if you could maybe write a review.
Oh, dear.
Or a nice long blurb.
I'm sorry, Mr.
Scott.
Yes. I don't lend out my name in that way.
You wouldn't be lending your name. You would be writing a blurb.
This is rather the same thing, isn't it?
No.
Mr. Fitz...
Look... If I don't get some word of mouth, I mean some major word of mouth, my book will die a short death. And you're about as major as they come. You just won the Pulitzer. If you praise my book, they will listen. People will listen.
I'm very sorry. How do you like your studies, Teddy?
Oh, very well. I'm studying with Nadia Boulanger.
Oh, yes, I've heard. I adore her music. Don't you, Mr. Scott?
Tea. You just ordered tea.
Yes, it shouldn't be more than a minute.
But this is France. There's no prohibition in this country.
Well, at times one feels there ought to be.
Has anyone seen the new Chaplin film?
Do you really serve tea, Mrs. Wharton?
Well, I must, mustn't I? I've just ordered it.
It's like something out of one of your novels.
Oh, where are you summer, Edith?
In Venice, with Henry James.
How wonderful.
Expensive. Venice is expensive.
We all know that, Scott.
Just pointing it out, that's all.
How about the new cinema on Champs-Élysées?
Mr. Fitz.
Scott. Actually, it's Francis, but I like Scott.
I am significantly older than you.
And?
Well, I have published many novels, we hope.
I'm sorry.
You must be patient. My first novel wasn't a success.
Your first novel was The House of Mirth.
That was my first published novel, not my first novel.
What was your first novel?
The Indiscretions of Lucinda.
When did you write that?
Oh, when I was 16.
I'm sorry. I know you're Edith Wharton and all, but you can't compare what a 16-year-old writes with my book, The Great Gatsby. I sweated over that book for 5 years as a grown-up.
How do you think it is an example?
It is a ridiculous example.
Scott.
I mean, you've never even had to go out and get a job. You've never had to support a wife or think about where your next meal is coming from.
From what I can see, your next meal will be coming from a bottle.
Why don't we all have tea?
No, I heard an interesting story the other day.
Scott.
I don't know you'll like this, Edith. It has a novelist's flair.
Well, do tell.
Okay, there were these two people, a man and a woman. They were married. Oh, no, wait a minute. They weren't married. They were just having an ordinary affair.
Scott?
No, and they were feeling pretty urgent, so they found a hotel.
Oh, dear.
And they went upstairs to relieve their urgency.
Scott?
As they were coming back downstairs, a porter stopped them and said, "Hey, she can't leave." And the first man said, "Oh, what the hell do you mean?
Teddy?"
Scott!
And the second man said, "We don't let our women out at night." "Your women," the first guy says. And the porter said, "Yeah, don't you know this is a whorehouse?" And they all had a good laugh.
I'm so sorry. I have another engagement.
Yes, of course.
I just thought you could use that in a book.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, you could put it between your tufted chairs or, you know, scattering around your decorative wallpaper.
I am so sorry, Edith.
Never mind.
Or you could hide it under the skirts of Lily Bart.
Get him a strong coffee, will you?
Let's go.
Really? We were just getting cozy.
Mr. Fitzgerald? Drink drives many men to an early grave. Don't deprive the world of your novels.
Get going. Get in.
I don't think that went too badly.
Don't you ever, ever ask me to go anywhere, ever again.
To talk with all by myself. know I'm too